Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a common problems video on the Ford 2.0 EcoBoost engine. The 2-liter EcoBoost is an inline four turbocharged direct injected design. It's now on its second generation, but it made its debut back in 2010, and it was actually based on the Mazda L engine. That ran through 2015 when Ford began switching over to the second gen. At this point, the co-op between Mazda and Ford had ended, and so Ford made some design tweaks, kind of redesigned the 2.0 EcoBoost and made a few other updates, like moving to a twin scroll turbocharger with an active wastegate, as well as higher compression, a couple other updates to help with reliability and horsepower and torque output of the 2.0 liter EcoBoost. Ultimately, this engine's good for anywhere from 160 to 250 horsepower from the factory. I believe actually up to 252 horsepower in the Ford Focus ST, and up to 280 pound-feet of torque. So there's that kind of larger power range, but most of these 2-liter EcoBoosts are gonna fall closer to the 200 to 250 horsepower ballpark. It's in quite a number of various Ford and Lincoln models, including the newest Ford Maverick small pickup truck. All right, so that covers most of the background information. There is quite a bit more that we could get into with the 2.0 EcoBoost, but we're gonna go ahead and jump right into some common problems with this 2-liter inline four turbocharged engine. Up first, one common issue with the 2.0 EcoBoost is a cracked exhaust manifold or leaking exhaust manifold. So that's a pretty simple issue. Your best bet is going to be replacing that exhaust manifold. However, it shouldn't cause any long-term reliability or longevity concerns. However, you might have a hard time passing emissions testing with a cracked manifold, and you'll also likely hear some ticking sounds and maybe smell some kind of raw gas smells with that cracked or leaking manifold. But again, shouldn't be a huge concern for the long term. Still better off to replace that sooner than later. Not a huge issue in the grand scheme for the 2.0 EcoBoost. Moving on to number two, another issue that a number of these EcoBoost engines run into are boost solenoid failures. They can also be referred to as turbo solenoids, but these boost solenoids just tend to eventually fail over time. Also not a major issue, a couple $100 probably to get those fixed, depending on whether you DIY that or take it to a repair shop. But once again, pretty minor issue in the grand scheme. Number three, another problem for the 2-liter EcoBoost is because it is a direct injected engine, it is subject to carbon buildup. We actually recently filmed a video on carbon buildup that will be in the description below. So check that out if you want more info on carbon buildup problems, what that looks like and how to solve it. But we'll give the quick kind of cliff notes here as well. First off, all engines produce some degree of oil blow-by. So this is oil that actually makes its way back into the intake tract, and it gets stuck to intake ports and intake valves. On port injected engines, they actually spray fuel into those intake ports, and detergents in the fuel can wipe away any of those oil deposits. But on direct injected engines, the fuel sprayed directly into the cylinder, so there's no fuel and no detergents to wipe off the oil deposits on the intake valves. And so ultimately that leads to the oil forming, deposits hardening, and then that becomes known as carbon buildup or carbon deposits. Over time, as that carbon continues to build up, you'll notice reduced power, you might run into misfires, just kind of a choppy or unsmooth idle, or maybe some stuttering or hesitation during acceleration. This is another problem that doesn't really affect reliability or longevity. It's mostly those drivability issues that will arise from carbon buildup. So it's still a good idea to go ahead and walnut blast or clean out those intake valves and ports roughly every 100,000 miles. Can probably stretch that a bit further. Chances are quite a few 2.0 EcoBoosts will go their whole lives without ever having any carbon clean from the intake valves. So again, it's not a huge issue, but if you want to make sure the engine is running at kind of optimum performance and avoid running into any drivability issues like a rough idle or stuttering or hesitation during acceleration, then again, good idea to go ahead and get those cleaned and walnut blasted roughly every 100,000 miles. If you want more info on carbon buildup, be sure to check out the video again in the description below. Let's move on to number four, which is a pretty significant and serious problem for the 2-liter EcoBoost. Really the biggest complaint and something that you can find all over forums and all over the internet. And that is a coolant intrusion into the cylinders of the 2-liter EcoBoost. So Ford does have a service bulletin for this. It primarily affects the 2015 to 2018 Ford Edge, as well as 2017 to 2019 Escape, Fusion, MKC, and MKZ models. Part of the issue is with these engine blocks, starting in 2015, again with the Ford Edge, Ford had moved to an open deck block design. And so that means it's better for cooling because there's actually space between the cylinder block and the cylinders themselves, and that helps with cooling, but it also leads to a slightly weaker engine block in general. And Ford also made some little dashes in between the cylinders as coolant channels. And so that makes it hard for the head gasket to properly seal to those cylinders. And additionally, the little coolant, the little crack or kind of crevice for coolant flow also leads to a weaker area in the block. And so one problem is the block cracking or ultimately the head gasket just not properly sealing to the block. And so you have coolant entering cylinders. Of course, that's a very serious issue and generally leads to complete engine replacement. So when that coolant actually enters the cylinders, chances are you'll notice misfires. You'll probably get a check engine light because obviously coolant in cylinders is going to affect the combustion process. So you'll usually see those misfires and engine codes. You might also notice white smoke from the exhaust as that coolant burns off inside of the cylinders. Or you might notice during an oil change that you actually have coolant mixing in there with the oil, and that will look kind of like a milky oil. So again, serious problem, coolant mixing with oil, coolant getting into the cylinders causes a lot of problems. It can cause serious engine damage. And really the solution and the fix, according to Ford's service bulletin, is a complete replacement of the long block, which again is necessary because coolant can cause significant damage when it enters the cylinders and especially when it's allowed to mix with oil. Fortunately, Ford did fix this issue in 2020. It's still an open deck cylinder block, but they changed the coolant passages a little bit and strengthened the area in between those cylinders. So cracking there is a lot less common, and it also gives a larger surface area for the head gasket to actually seal to the block and prevent coolant from getting into any of the cylinders. One final note on this topic, it typically happens right between cylinders 2 and 3. So about right in the middle of the engine is where these problems typically pop up. Serious issue. Fortunately, it was only an issue for a couple years on those Escapes, Ford Edge, Lincoln MKC, MKZ. So not something that affects every engine. And again, anything 2020 plus, Ford did update the design and it seems like that is an effective fix. So hopefully that holds up and continues into the long run. Just looking at the design, it does look like it should prevent these issues from being commonplace moving forward. But again, serious issues, so something to be aware of if you're looking for one of those models in the year ranges that we just discussed a few minutes ago. Otherwise, that just about covers everything for 2.0 EcoBoost common problems. Of course, there are random fluky failures that happen. Any car, not just the 2.0 EcoBoost, is subject to various different failures, but that pretty much covers the most common and most significant issues on the 2.0 EcoBoost. Ultimately, keep up with maintenance, the basic stuff that you should do on any car, any engine, use quality oils, change fluids on time. When problems arise, fix them in a timely manner. Keep up with all the basics, and the 2.0 EcoBoost can be a great engine that can easily make it to 200,000 plus miles with a few severe issues along the way. If you guys like this video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the 2.0 EcoBoost. Thanks, guys.